A state Senate committee takes aim at violence in Baltimore. Members of the Senate, along with city delegates, heard testimony today about the extent of and the best approach to Baltimore's crisis of crime. Political reporter Pat Warren reports from Annapolis. Lawmakers believe all of Maryland has a stake in this.
Getting to the bottom of Baltimore's troubles means digging deep, with 245 homicides so far this year.
There's a tremendous loss of life that's going on. The violence is in a proportion that I haven't seen since my time down here. It's having an economic impact, and it has an impact, you know, on all of us.
This is the plan that we campaigned on.
And the mayor says putting that plan in action is going to require more resources.
And what we are seeing right now is an increase in juveniles, being from 14 all the way up until 18, 14, 15-year-olds just this past week. I've had several cases where we've had to charge 14 and 15-year-olds with gun possession. They're bringing loaded firearms into the schools.
This packed hearing room is more than an audience. It's agencies, communities, and organizers who recognize the emergency.
We're not sitting in City Hall in the dark. And when I, in January, said I need everybody, all hands on deck, to help us reduce violence in the city, I did what I call a call to action.
And members of the General Assembly getting on board, Senate Judicial Chairman Bobby Zirkin leading the cause.
Whether you live in the city or across the city line, which is where I live, or anywhere across the state, what is happening in Baltimore City means something to the state.
That means funding and legislation will be a priority. There are no easy answers, and they may have only scratched the surface with today's hearing. Another is scheduled for later in Baltimore. I'm Pat Warren reporting. Now back to you.
And the date for that hearing has not been set.